So we will discuss today on the financial derivative model 3 on option time value and the intrinsic value, or what we call as moneyness, right? So here we will try to understand what is intrinsic value and the time value from which is extracted from the option price, or what we call as an option value, right? And also we'll try to make a note here with respect to the moneyness. We are already familiar with the moneyness, that is what is in the money, at the money, and out of the money, okay? And this is also the similar problem which has been asked in the last year question paper, so that would be very helpful for you for the coming exam. Let's try to understand the question here. Or before we go to the question, let's try to understand the fundamentals of what is intrinsic value and the time value. Okay, that help us to better understand the concept of time value and the intrinsic value. Okay, so these are the two components of the option premium or the option price, right? When you look at what is option price is nothing but the option premium, which we calculate by using the various models like Black-Scholes model or the binomial model, right? If you want to enter either the holder like in a call or the put, so you pay the option premium, right? That option premium includes two components, that is intrinsic value of the time value. Let's try to understand this concept of intrinsic value. Let's first from the point of call option and the put option, then the time value. Time value remains the same for call and the put, the equation. Fine. So what is intrinsic value here, right? The premium on the price of an option is made up of the two components, as we understand, that is intrinsic value of the time value. The intrinsic value is also termed as a parity value, right? The intrinsic value, what we call as in a parity value, the real value, what you get by entering into this option, right? That is what we call as a intrinsic value, right? The moneyness, basically the in the money. Intrinsic value refers to the payoff that you are going to realize. So here it would be only a positive value. It would be either the in the money or it would be out the money. It will not be in a out of the money, right? Any positive cash flows that you are going to realize is what we call as an intrinsic value. Then the time value as a difference between the premium and the intrinsic value is what we call as a time value. Means as a time passes, right, how much is the real thing that you are going to realize? That is deducting from the premium that you have been paid, right? So intrinsic value is only the difference, right, excluding the premium. Time value refers to the including your premium, how much is the net payoff that you are going to realize, which is positive or it is a zero. Okay, coming to the intrinsic value for a call option, that is in the money, where the intrinsic value is excess of the stock price. Fine. So if you want to calculate the intrinsic value for the call option, what is that you take here is, first you take the spot price, what is the prevailing spot price in the market, minus the strike price or the exercise price. The difference between the spot price minus exercise price, that is always you have a in the money for a call option when the spot price which is trading in the market should be greater than the exercise price or the strike price. When it is greater, you will be executing the call option and you will make a profit. That is what we call as in a intrinsic value, right? When the spot price in the market which is less than the strike price, then it is out of the money, right? So there is no moneyness concept here. So then we have to take that as a zero there. Fine. So that is the intrinsic value. Or the intrinsic value would be zero when the spot price and the intrinsic value both are the same, then the intrinsic value would be the zero. Okay, so this is the equation for a call option where the spot price minus the strike price. Coming to the same of calculating the intrinsic value for an put option, which is when is that you can say that the put option is going to be the in the money, right? So put option is going to be put option is said to be the in the money when the exercise price is greater than the spot price. It means the spot price should be less in the market than the exercise price. So the equation is exercise price minus the spot price, right? The spot price should be less than the exercise price for the put option, where there is a in the money for a put option. When the spot price is greater than the exercise price, then it is a in the money for a call option. Fine. So time value refers to the difference of the between the premium and the intrinsic value which we have been calculated, right? So what is the premium that we have been paying? That is option value minus the intrinsic value is what we call as a time value, right? So this is about the simple about intrinsic value of the time value. Now let's take up the one problem and try to understand. Okay, so here we have a given data regarding the Nifty 50, right? So exercise prices are being given for different, right? But we need to take into consideration only that exercise price where the premium is available. When you say 1060 for a call, there is no premium, so you don't have to consider for calculating intrinsic value or the time value. Then we say 1080 for call premium, there is no data is available, so hence you don't have to touch upon this exercise price. Fine. Then you have a 1100, you need to take that into consideration till 1220 for which the call premium has been given. So you have to calculate the time value and the intrinsic value for this option, that is for a call. Similarly, for the put option, for 1060 the premium is given, right? Till for 1160 the premium is given. For 1180, 1200 and 1220 the premium is not being given. That you don't have to calculate the intrinsic value or the time value. Okay, the index opened at 1146.05. so what does this indicate is the spot price. The spot price here is 1146.05 and intrinsic value is being given, which should be started for a call option at 1100, right? So then calculate the intrinsic value and the time value, and also the moneyness talks about in the money, at the money and out of the money. Okay, these are the three things that we need to look at. Let's start. So first thing, what is that you need to do here is, when you start solution, writing the solution, first write down first column as a intrinsic value which is been given, right? So the intrinsic value which is given is 1060, 1080, 1100, 1120, 1140, 1160, 1180, 1200 and 1220. Next column, write down a common spot price, right? So common spot price for all the different strike prices, right? But spot price is a common, but we have a different strike prices. Okay, so first column is the exercise price and the second column is a spot price. When you write down these two, then go to the next column. Next column heading write down as a category. Category is nothing but the moneyness. Since, as I said, like for a call premium in the given question, for 1060 and 1080, right? So there is no premium. When there is no premium given, so we don't have to calculate the solution for the moneyness, intrinsic value or the time value. So we'll start from 1100, right? So exercise price is 1100 and the spot price is 1146.05, right? The spot price is greater than the exercise price, where you have a right to buy at 1100, right? You buy at 1100 and you can sell in the market for 1146.05, right? So you can make a profit of 46.05. that is what we call as intrinsic value. So here the first thing what is that we are calculating is a moneyness. Moneyness referred to the whether it is in the money, at the money and out of the money. So it is in the money. Similarly, 1120 it is in the money, 1140 it is in the money. But you come to 1160, excess price is 1160, the spot price is 1146. Here the excess price, right to buy, is greater than the spot price, hence you will not execute, you will withdraw. Then the situation is called as out of the money. And the same case for 1180, 1200 and 1220. So this is the first solution what we call as a moneyness, where we identify whether it is in the money, at the money and out of the money. Okay, now the next column thing what we need to do is, we need to update the call premium which has been given in the question, right? In the call premium which has been given for 1100. So for 1160 and 1180 is there, just leave it blank. From 1100 it is given the premium, just update the premium into the same solution, right? So next thing what we'll try to do is, we'll calculate the intrinsic value for in a call option. As we know that the formula for calculating the intrinsic value for the call option is, that is the difference between the spot price minus excess price. First you need to take the S naught minus E. S naught minus E either is a positive value, right? We need to update that. If it is a zero, you can update it, but it cannot be negative value. So you should not take the negative values there, right? So then let's look at S0. S0 is what? 1146.05 minus 1100. The intrinsic value is 46.05. That is positive value that you are going to realize the cash from the call option. Similarly, at 1120, the difference when you take, you will get 26.05. At 1140, the 6.05, right? Now it comes to 1160, right? S0 is 1146.05 minus 1160. Then you are going to get that as a negative value. So hence the intrinsic value cannot be negative as per the formula what they say. Either you have to write it as zero or you have to write it as a positive value. Since it is a negative value, we will not take the negative value, we will take only the positive value, or we'll consider that as a zero if it is out of the money. For all out of the money, we have to mention as a zero, because you're going to get that as a negative, you're not going to execute that. Fine, that is with respect to intrinsic value. Now the next column heading, writing it as a time value. Okay, time value, calculation of time value for the call option. When you want to calculate the time value for the call option, the difference that you're supposed to take is the premium, right? The premium minus the intrinsic value. So premium of the call option at 1100 is 50 minus the intrinsic value is 46.05, and you get the time value is 3.95. So this is what you're going to actually realize the profit when you hold the contract till the date of expiry, right? So similarly, for 1120 exercise price, you will have a time value as 5 rupees. At 1140, 11, right? So 1168, 1180, 4.5, 1200, 2.75, 1221. So what does the time value indicates is, so you will be having maximum profit, right? So you will have a maximum value of the profit or inflow when you have the time value, or when you have the intrinsic, when you have the strike price and the current market price are very closer, or both are at the money, you will find maximum time value. Now if you look at 1140 and 1146, right, they are very closer, then you have a maximum or a maximum positive time value. Okay, that is 1100. Fine. So this is how about calculating the intrinsic value and the time value for the call option. Now we'll proceed to calculating for the put option. Right. The same case, what we are supposed to do is first write down what is the excess price given in the question, then the spot price, which is common for a call and the put. Right. So once the update is been done, the column one excess price, column two the spot price, right? Then comes a column three that calls the moneyness of a put option. Right. When you want to know the moneyness, whether it's in the money, at the money, and out of the money, here the condition here is the strike price should be greater than the spot price. When the strike price is greater than the spot price, or the spot price is less than the strike price, then the put option would be in the money. Right. If the spot price is greater than the strike price, then it is out of the money. Right. Here, when you look at here, the strike price is 1160 and spot price is greater than the exercise price. So hence it is out of the money. Right. Similarly, 1880 out of the money, 1100 out of the money, 1120 out of the money, 1140 out of the money, 1160. Right, excess price is 1160, but the spot price is less, so it is in the money. So next, 1180, 1200, 1220, we are not calculating because the premium is not given in the question. Right, so the next column heading, you are supposed to write the premium which is given in the question. Now we move on to calculating intrinsic value and the time value for the put option. Right, so intrinsic value, what is the formula here? The intrinsic value is again exercise price minus spot price. It should be positive, if not, it should be zero. If it is negative value, it should be zero. Right, so exercise price should be greater than the spot price. In the first case, exercise price is 11,060 and spot price is 1146. Here the spot price is greater than excess price, where we have a negative value, so hence we take the intrinsic value as a zero. The same case for 1180, 1100, 1120, 1140, we take it as a zero because here we get a negative value. But in the case of 1160, the excess price, right, and the spot price is 1148, where you have a right to buy at 1160 when the market price is 1146.05, you will definitely, in the put option, what you have a, your right to sell. In the put option, you have a right to sell for 1160, right? When the market price is less, you definitely sell it. So it is in the money, and the premium is 23, right? So difference between that excess price and the spot price you get is 1113.95. that is intrinsic value, time value, that is difference between premium and the intrinsic value, that is 9.45. This is how you can calculate the intrinsic value and the time value for the call option as well as like for the put option. Okay, with this we'll stop the discussion.